I'm Karen Craig, I'm the Program Director at Living Rock, and I'm really excited to be here at the Gasworks, this beautiful venue in downtown Hamilton, where we're celebrating the 22nd annual Arts of August. And so youth are submitting art, poetry, photography, music, dance. We've got a performance here tonight related to peace, equality, love, and culture. And I love the themes, and I know youth are telling me, you know what, I've now done these themes 4 or 5 years, and I'm seeing the impact of touching on these incredible topics. They're making themselves vulnerable and open, and they're sharing their bio, who they are, as well as how do they relate the piece that they've created to the theme of peace, equality, love, culture. And we've got incredible judges from the community. I love it when they hear the voice of the artists as they speak to them in their language and tell them how remarkable their works are. People are making comments to the artists as well on comment cards, so they're going to get feedback from the audience as well. We're really excited that we have the support of Canada Summer Jobs. The City of Hamilton stands with us under Heritage and Culture. And we've got all kinds of sponsors that are donating prizes and participating in the event as well. So we're so thankful for our community rallying together to do something really important and create a culture of peace in our city. So thank you so much for being involved in Arts of August. 67 artists here have contributed. Isn't that amazing? So powerful.
As non-Indigenous peoples to this land, it is our responsibility to pay homage, give thanks, remark as continuous allies with Indigenous communities, and stand in solidarity as settlers of this land. Living Rock Ministries recognizes and acknowledges that its organization and the Arts of August exhibit hosted at the Gasworks is located on the traditional territories of the Mississaugas of the Credit First Nation, the Haudenosaunee, Anishinaabeg, and the Attawan-Lenawk Nations. These territories have been protected and preserved for millennia by the Indigenous peoples of Turtle Island through their ways of being, coexistence with the land and each other, as well as the protection of the knowledge. These lands are covered by Treaty 3, 1792, between the Lakes Purchase, as well as the District 1 Spoon, 1 Palm Bell Covenant, which extends across the province of Ontario. Why the notion that resources be shared and replenished after each person takes from the bowl, so that all may have a chance to equally benefit. Through our own journeys and walks of life, we have ended up here in what is currently known as Canada. We are neighbors with each other. We eat from the same roots and drink water from the same streams, but we cannot bear ignorance for the mass disproportionate amounts of Indigenous peoples in Turtle Island who continue to face colonial violence perpetrated by our own systems and individual mindsets. We must work to undo and move forward. When we protect each other, we protect our future. A common saying in Indigenous communities, both here on Turtle Island and around the world, is think 7 generations ahead. Not only for them do we stand here today, but we stand as a community ready for action as true allies. Thank you.
Hi everyone, my name is Rachel Vincent. I'm coming from you from the Arts of August Team 2024. I'm so proud to be a part of this event. Arts of August, a wonderful event for youth age 13-25 to submit any medium of art, because how else can you best express yourself if you're not expressing yourself through art? Be sure to submit next year for Arts of August. We want to see your art. Hope to see you there. Take care.
Hi, my name is Sienna. I work at the Living Rock. I'm with Focus on Youth, and I've been working with them throughout the summer. It is a great pleasure working with all of them because I get to learn new things and experience new opportunities that I haven't learned. And it's really great to meet them, and they're so nice to us, and we will miss them all.
My name is Masa, and I'm a newcomer youth mentorship program facilitator with the YMCA. It's been such a pleasure working towards this event today, the Arts of August event. We've been collaborating with Karen at the Living Rock, and our youth have been involved in the program through our Summer Lens program. Majority of our youth are going through a tough time, so it's been really nice for them to get out, go on photography walks, spend some time indoors on rainy days, working on their art. And they've been looking forward to this big day. It's a pleasure to be here, and I'm looking forward to it.
How's it going? This is Marcel Da Costa from Wesley Youth Services and the HRIC. Just here at Living Rock's annual event, the Art Showcase with Youth. And it's honestly an incredible event. You have youth from all over Hamilton, and they're dropping pieces, whether it's music or paintings or writings, and they're just coming from every different perspective. And if you're not here, you should be here. It's my honor and privilege to be here, so thanks for having me, y'all.
Thank you. absolutely love for you all to still check out the art, and of course make comment cards to the artists. We would all love that. Yes, enjoy the rest of the show.
Hi, my name is Theo Roselle. I was performing at Arts of August. I think it's good for youth to be able to show others their art in a way that they don't have to like try to sell their art or anything. They can just showcase it and everyone can just come for free and see it.
My name is Murray. I work over at the Living Rock. I've been there now for about 5 years. And it is amazing. It brings together so many people of our community. Not only the youth that are involved directly with the Rock, but also the youth at large. And it brings together so many incredibly talented artists under one roof. So is this something I would encourage people to come out and check out for themselves? Of course it is. So if you guys have any kind of sense of aesthetics and want to have a good time, come on out. Support the Living Rock. Support our Arts of August. Come on down and be a part of the family.
And judging, but first thing I want to talk about a very special award.
So this is the beautiful sunflower that was done by Shelby, who passed in 2014. It was her Arts of August submission. You can see how beautiful it is. And so Living Rock staff every year now come together and we decide who is going to be our Sunshine Award at Living Rock for their involvement and care. In recognition of a participant who has been an encouragement to the community and a cheerleader for their peers, winner this year is Jamal Samuels. If you can come up, Jamal. At Living Rock. Jamal, come on over here. If any work needs to happen, Jamal's on it. He does every job. Even today, he was like, how can I help you guys to get ready for Arts of August? Did you read the program and see your name, your picture in it?
Yes.
That's awesome. So we're so excited, and his mom's here tonight, I think, too. Yay, there's Jennifer right there. So, yeah. Do you want to say anything?
Thank you.
And we have a special prize and certificate we'll be doing for Jamal. So thank you so much.
Hi, my name is Jamal Samuels. I'm with the Living Rock right now, hopping up for tonight. It is Arts of August, where they are supported by you. Living Rock is a fantastic place. They can give you access to anything, showers, drop-in, Wi-Fi.
My name is Nicholas Reed, and I'm here on behalf of The Rock to help set up Arts of August. I have been going to The Rock for the better part of 9 years now, and they have been a big help in keeping out of trouble and getting something productive to do.
Hello, my name is Michael Hall. And I am a teacher and photographer with Bishop Ryan Catholic Secondary School. And I'm a judge here at the Living Rock Arts for August event. I've been lucky enough to be here to view some amazing photography and some outstanding artists. It's an opportunity for them to shine. It's an opportunity for them to showcase their work and have others view it.
Thank you for having me. It's an honor to be here. And we're first going to start with technical mentions in photography. We're going to look at the artist known as Please Stop. Round of applause. These are some of the finest photograph or illustrations I have seen in a long time. They are outstanding collages, and I believe that this is an exceptional talent. Round of applause. Way to go. Fantastic.
So this is a collection of fan art of drag queens. I have a major drag queen obsession, and I'm a drag artist myself.
Thank you.
Yeah. I've been doing drag and design for about 9 years now, and this collage style is just something I've mastered, so thank you for appreciating me.
Thank you. I appreciate it. Please stop, everybody. Second runner-up, ladies and gentlemen, Sylvan and Nahi, please and thank you. When I was looking at these images, I was particularly struck at this image here. But when we're looking at the leading lines coming in that draw your eye to the wonderful fashion, as well as this is your image here where we have the light streaks coming across from the sun. It's outstanding, outstanding, well done. We have Elham. Elham with the photography coach. I like this, see, teamwork. No. But no, outstanding. You talk about nature and loving our environment, and we talk about the creator, talking about how we need to be taking care of the earth and how we're supporting our environment. And this particularly seems so fitting to go with what we've done. So outstanding job, fantastic. I love the composition.
Yeah. So the main point in this picture is not that I wanted to add a beautiful picture. So the main reason behind this picture is this message that Lake Ontario, a huge resource of fresh water, made it polluted. And now a big part of nature's life and a big resource of fresh water is useless. We lost the system in that lake. Yeah. So that's the main point of this picture. Thank you.
Our winner for best photo goes to Ryan with two N's. Way to go. Ryan, congratulations. This is outstanding. And we talked about the theme. When you look at this, is you talk about peace and the peacefulness. This is perfect. If you look at it, there's the wonderful light that's leading your eye. So the moonlight coming right into the middle of the camera leads your eye up to the moon. Then you have the cloud that's breaking up the line between the light and the actual moon. Outstanding work. Fantastic. Well done.
I just wanted to give a big thank you to Living Rock. A huge thank you that I can't even begin to describe for being a safe space I could go to for years, helping me in my darkest moments, and for showcasing all this amazing work. And thank you to judges for giving me first place there.
Hi, my name is Ryan. This is my submission for Arts of August 2024. It is a photo of Bernard Lake that is a few hours up north. I chose the subject of love for it and peace.
Hi, I'm Rose DeVicha, and this is my third year helping out at Arts of August. Always so inspired by the work I see by the young artists here. I'm the literary judge. This is my third year having the honor of judging some of the wonderful works we see here by the youth of Hamilton. Good evening, everyone. First mention goes to our technical category. This writer uses repetition to highlight the cause and effect, which results in young love, and highlights the often bumpy course of relationships. For up and down, she's all around, my mind, myself. Congratulations, Michaela Matza.
Arts of August inspires me to focus deeply on our project and have a good large audience see it and tell me how they feel about it.
Our third place winner focuses on love following trauma to emphasize the need for human connection, citing enough, 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 and finally ending with a more positive, lighthearted passage. This text reflects on past lessons learned to move forward. For cheers, congratulations, Jem Goldsworthy. Our second place winner writes about equality, shared spaces, and isolation. This text challenges the reader to embrace their significance and self-worth while coming together to support one another. For Shared Spaces, congratulations, Amalia Morgan. For our first place winner, this poem uses imagery and symbolism to reflect upon heritage, tradition, and culture. It evokes feelings of family, feasting, and celebration through the author's own experiences while speaking of dances, laughter, and songs, and the blessings of spring. Pride of tradition and culture shines through this piece. For the people of the mountain and the sun, congratulations, Rulan Muhammad.
Hey, I'm Rulan Muhammad.
I'm Nala.
I'm Silva.
And we're the artists at Arts of August.
Thanks for having us, Arts of August.
Hi, my name is Natty. I use they, them pronouns. I am a judge for the Arts of August 2024, and I'm very thankful that this is my third year that I get to do this. In my personal life, I do a lot of work around housing for students and for young adults. And so in my spare time, it always feels rewarding to be able to look at the work that youth are working on in the community, specifically their artistic works, their cultural works. Being able to take a moment and appreciate the things that bring value to life makes it worth it. And so I'm always happy to be able to celebrate that and the work that Living Rock is doing and Arts of August is doing to bring folks together to do just that. So I'm happy to be here and thank you so much.
My name is Kevin Williamson and I'm the live performance judge for Arts of August 2024. Arts of August is a great event for the community. Not only does it bring people together, but it gives youth the opportunity to showcase their unbelievable talents.
Ladies and gentlemen, for our live performance winner, please make some noise for Theo Rosal. I think y'all can do a little better than that. So Theo, what I wanted to say about your performance, it was fantastic. Thank you for being the only person to make it up to the stage. It's not easy to perform alone. It's not easy to be the first person to perform. So congratulations on being our winner. For the first technical mention that I wanted to add is a painting that has so much fun and unique colors and shapes. And it's called 444 Love by Angel Madison Merritt. Would you like to say anything?
So I kind of fell in love with Posca markers. So I did this with Posca markers and it's like a self-portrait that originally the chains were kind of just like in the background, not really intentionally placed. But then my wonderful partner gave me the idea of actually giving the character in the piece control of the chains to kind of show that you can control your love a little bit more and how you kind of show up and be loving. So that's that, and that's my piece.
Thank you. Good technical mention for the evening is a very skillfully drawn piece, amazing artwork. It's a masterpiece in my opinion, so skillful. Please make some noise for the Kraken, which is by Mercy Abraka. Our second runner-up for this theme is a great piece called The Lighthouse, which is a great expression of love because it guides you through passages and rough waters. So I'd like to invite Bernard to come up here and take some credit for his amazing piece.
I would like to say a big thank you to my sister, Jim Goldsworthy, for pushing me into this, because I originally didn't really want to, but thank you so much for helping me get closer to my dream of opening a studio.
We will get there. Make some noise for her. Show some love. Our first runner-up, with a great piece called The parentheses He Art of Soul. I think it's a great example of love because of the single tear heart droplet. You know, it represents the type of difficulties that come with a broken heart and trying to mend your heart. So please make some noise for Sienna and Dea.
I just want to say thank you to everybody here and thank you to the judges as well. And to the Living Rock staff. You guys are wonderful. Thank you so much.
Final winner for the love category comes from a great piece called Mere Days by Kyra Clark. And I love this piece because I grew up with a single mom and my mom does everything for me. She's my world. And this shows the expression of a love between a mother and child. Would you like to accept? This is your award, right?
My name is Thomas.
Make some noise for Thomas, everybody!
But we're going to start off in a traditional way. We're going to start with some technical mentions. The first is actually, well, I had a couple of technical mentions, but shouts out to Sierra Williamson. Shouts out to the Peace of the Planet Department. It was a really simple, but like technically beautiful and really stunning to see the relationship the planets have with each other, the kind of reciprocity that's there. Sierra's clearly skilled in the way that they use texture and in form, and so thank you so much for capturing and sharing that.
There you go.
Now, I should also note that the Black Hole Abyss also received a technical mention. But our next technical mention is by Abel Fazl. Abel Fazl's painting of a calm moonlit night on the lake is meticulously and technically well done. Immediately made me think about spending time at the cottage, my time out east on the ocean, and so I really appreciate that.
I just want to say thank you, everybody, for being here, and have a good time.
Thank you so much. But our next technical mention is by Sarah. Sarah's happy at it. Yeah. And I think that there was really so much with this piece. I mean, Sarah says that Sarah's grandpa owns a farm on the mountainside, and on the other side of that mountain they have a village and about 40 people, and that Sarah's grandpa didn't know them but built homes for them. Absolutely fantastic, and I think it really does speak to the kind of peace that you can acquire and build with strangers. So thank you so much for sharing that with us, Sarah. Next technical mention by Jordan Samuels. It's really just a beautifully designed and illustrated piece. It kind of captures that heart and the same embrace of one another's. Really like how the roses grow from this kind of harmonic embrace, and there's a super strong narrative that's told and captured with the bio. And we're at our second runner-up. This was a piece by Madison Merritt. Ouch. This was a really, really awesome, original, modern piece. It had great contract, line work. There's the figure of the heart stabbed and, you know, taking steps towards recovery, growth. Thank you so much for helping us grow. That's really awesome. Next, we have our first runner-up, Marja. Marja's work shared the experience of a girl who had been impacted by things we often see on the news and or on the internet. And it really juxtaposed the here and now from the dawn of a new day at sunrise, and this wanton desire to remain playful and hold out hope, kind of depicted and captured with that paper airplane. So thank you so much, Marja. Okay. And then finally, we have our winner, Mercy, for the Insomniac. It took me like a second and a third visit when I was browsing by. It's dark but inviting. It's really creative. It's warm. It captures this kind of liminality. And honestly, just want to say thank you so much for sharing your struggle, but also your pursuits. So.
First technical mention for this category goes to Sierra Williamson. I thought this was a great piece. And, you know, I thought it was a fantastic piece overall and a great representation of the theme. So make some noise for Sierra. Technical mention is from a piece called Strawberry Tranquility by Maya Lagaro. It's such a skilled piece with great line work and detail, all the coloring and shading. Second runner-up, but it's Mercy with another great piece called Mother Chaska, which is absolutely amazing. All the beautiful textures and colors. It's such a great expression of the Peruvian heritage. This next piece is super cool, super Canadian. I like to call it the Timmy's Dumpster. No, Anthony Giovanetti. This is such a cool piece, and it's a statement piece for Canada and for Hamilton. And this would be the winner of today's category. Hiba Hashim, Equestrian Embrace. This piece is a great example of Middle Eastern culture go together so effortlessly and seamlessly.
Folks, we got our last category here, which is equality. These pieces, our first technical mention is Hannah's Equality of Life. I actually really, really appreciated the passage and how this relates to the theme, because it asks us to pause and appreciate the beauty of the smaller things in life that sometimes we overlook. Thank you so much, Hannah, for reminding us to take a closer look. Our next technical mention was just, this is the tree by Sohail. And again, I agree with Sohail. I really like the colors that were used in the background. I'm 100% in agreement. And thank you so much for bringing us that warmth from the sunset. So thank you so much, Sohail. And then we have Dominic's sculpture, Teardrop of God. So Dominic's Teardrop of God is a playfully creative way of molding into a physical form, sometimes a really difficult and nuanced concept. And so from the color to the form and everything that got put into it, thank you so much, Dominic, for sharing that.
Well, this piece wasn't really supposed to happen, but hey, accidents happen, right?
Best ones do. Thank you. We have our second runner-up, which is Abby's Growth. This growth really connected to the theme. It uses this kind of black paisley-esque line work. It contrasts with the bright and vibrant colors from the flowers. And it carries what I thought was a very important message, that people like flowers each need their own fair chances to grow and to succeed. And it was a poignant piece, a poignant narrative. So thank you so much. Okay, we have our first runner-up, which is Leo's Gender Dysphoria. Leo says, being trans, that's all we want, to be treated equally. And I think that take on gender dysphoria really captures the shared sense of humanness, the heart, literally hidden behind those kind of complex and sometimes perplexing relationship that we can have with gender, transitioning, and pursuing equality for trans people. So it's a really unique piece that literally tears apart gender norms. And thank you so much for sharing your humanity.